Hello guys, welcome to I Can Crack It. In this session, we will start with the chapter Ratio, Proportion and Variation. So, let us first jump into the basics. What is a ratio then? Ratio is comparison of any two or more similar quantities. For example, we can compare weight of one person with the weight of another person. So we can compare the similar quantities. You cannot compare the weight with the length. They will be different quantities. Okay. Now let us take an example then. So you can see here, they have given two weights here. The weight of A is 48 kg and weight of B is 32 kg. What is the ratio here? Ratio of weights of A and B is given by 48:32. So this is how we represent the ratio using the symbol colon. Now generally ratio is represented using A:B. This ratio can also be written in the form A/B. A:B can also be written in the form A/B. Now you can take this example. 48:32 can also be written in the form 48/32. Now this 48:32, okay, you can see both the numbers have a common factor of 16. So we can simplify this ratio by dividing by the common factor. 48 you can divide by the common factor 16, and also 32 you can divide by the common factor 16. 16 ones are 16 threes are, 16 ones are 16 twos are. So the new ratio we get is 3:2. 48:32 is same as 3:2. So this approach we use when the values are given and we need to find the ratio. We can divide the ratio by a common factor. Okay. We have seen if the values are given, we have calculated the ratio. What if the ratio is given and we need to calculate the values? So let us take an example. They have given the ratio. The ratio is 2:5 and the quantities are nothing but the lengths here. So what we need to find is, we need to find the lengths. Now the length of A, we can take it as 2 into x, where x is a common number, and length of B we can take it as 5 into x. So if the ratio of lengths of A and B is given as 2:5, then the lengths of A and B we can take it as 2 into x 2x, and 5 into x 5x. So let us take one more example. Now let us take the weights of A and B are given in the ratio 2:3. Now how do you take the weights? Now we can take the weights as 2x and 3x, 2 times the common number x and 3 times the common number x. So 2 into x 2x, and 3 into x 3x. These are the weights of A and B. Okay, now let us see the types of ratios. Let us take the ratio as A:B. There are 4 different types of ratios. If the given ratio is A:B, then the duplicate ratio is defined as A² to B². If the given ratio is A:B, then duplicate ratio is defined as A² to B². Now, if the given ratio is 3:5, then the duplicate ratio is 3² to 5². 3 square is what? 9:25. 5² is 25. So the duplicate ratio of 3:5 is nothing but 9:25. Now subduplicate ratio. If given ratio is A:B, then subduplicate ratio is given by √A:√B. Now let us take an example. If the given ratio is 16:49, now the subduplicate ratio is what? √16:49. root 16 is nothing but 4 is to root 49 is nothing but 7. So the subduplicate ratio of 16 is to 49 is nothing but 4 is to 7. Now, if the given ratio is A is to B, then triplicate ratio is given by A cube is to B cube. Triplicate ratio is given by A cube is to B cube. Let us take an example. If the given ratio is 2 is to 3, its triplicate ratio is given by 2 cube is to 3 cube. 2 cube is 8 is to 3 cube is 27. So the triplicate ratio of 2 is to 3 is nothing but 8 is to 27. Now the fourth one, subtriplicate ratio. If the given ratio is A is to B, the subtriplicate ratio is given by cube root of A is to cube root of B. Let us take an example. If the given ratio is 27 is to 64, the subtriplicate ratio is given by cube root of 27 is to cube root of 64. Cube root of 27 is nothing but 3. Cube root of 64 is nothing but 4. So the subtriplicate ratio of 27 is to 64 is nothing but 3 is to 4. The next concept is combining of ratios. So here they will be giving you two ratios or three ratios, and they will be asking you the combined ratio. For example, A is to B is given as 2 is to 3. B is to C is given as 3 is to 5. Then they have asked the combined ratio of A, B, C. Now you can observe here, in this particular example, in both the cases B is common, and you can see the value of B is same here. In such case, we can write the ratio A is to B is to C directly. B term is common and the value of B is same in both cases. In such case, we can write the ratio A is to B is to C directly. How? A is 2 units, so I'll write 2. B is 3 in both the cases, so I'll write 3. C is 5. I write 5. So A is 2, B is 2, C is nothing but 2 is 2, 3 is 2, 5. This approach is applicable only if the common term has same values. Here B is a common term and it has same values, that is 3 in both the cases. Now let us see an example. What if the value of B is different in both the cases? Here A is to B is given as 2 is to 3. B is to C is given as 4 is to 5. Then the combined ratio of A, B, C is asked. In this example, B term is common and the value of B is different in both the cases. So now let us see how to find the combined ratios. Which term is common here? The term B is common. That term you should write in the middle. The term B is common, I'll write in the middle. The remaining two terms are A and C. A is to B is how much? 2 is to 3. So I'll write 2 is to 3. Next, B is to C is how much? 4 is to 5. I write 4 is to 5. Now here we have two empty spaces, here and here. So in the empty space, write the common number. I mean, here we have 4. This is a common number, right? So here we have 4. So we write 4 here. Now here what is the common number? 3, right? So we'll write 3 in the empty space. To find A is to B is to C, multiply the first row and the second row. 2 into 4 is 8. 3 into 4 is 12. 3 into 5 is 15. Now A is to B is to C is nothing but 8 is to 12 is to 15. You may find it little lengthier now, but when you got used to it in exam, it becomes very useful approach. Let us see one more example. Here they are given A is to B as 2 is to 3, A is to C as 5 is to 7. Now they have asked the ratio A is to B is to C. Here what is the common term? Common term is A. The common term you should write in the middle. The remaining two terms I write here, B and C. A is to B is 2 is to 3. Now B is to A is the reverse, 3 is to 2. So I take 3 here and 2 here. A is to C is 5 is to 7. So I write 5 here, 7 here. This empty space should be written with 2. This empty space should be written with 5. Now what is the ratio? Multiply both the rows. 3 into 5, 15. 2 into 5, 10. 2 into 7, 14. This is the ratio of B is to A is to C. They have asked A is to B is to C. It is given by 10 is to 15 is to 14. 10 is to 15 is to 14. Now let us see one more example where three ratios are given. A is to B is 2 is to 3. B is to C is 4 is to 5. C is to D is 3 is to 2. They have asked the ratio of A and D. I mean you need to find A is to D. You cannot simply write A is to D as 2 is to 2. You need to find the ratio A is to B is to C is to D. Then only you can find A is to D. A is to B is given as 2 is to 3. So I'll write 2 is to 3 here. B is to C is 4 is to 5. C is to D is 3 is to 2. Now we have empty space here. So we'll replace with 3. 3 and 3 here. Empty space we'll replace with 5. Empty space we'll replace with 4. Empty space we'll replace with 3 and 3. Now let us check, are there any common terms? Here you can see 3, 3, 3 and 3. 3 is common in all the columns. So we can cancel out the common terms. Now multiply the remaining numbers. 2 into 4 is 8. 4 into 3 is 12. 5 into 3 is 15. 5 into 2 is 10. Now the ratio of A is to B is to C is to D is nothing but 8 is to 12 is to 15 is to 10. What they have asked? They have asked A is to D. So what is A is to D now? 8 is to 10. A is 8 and D is 10. Now simplify this. 2 fours are, 2 fives are. So what is A is to D then? A is to D is 4 is to 5. Now you can see here, if you could have written directly, you could have got 2 is to 2. So which is wrong? A is to D is nothing but here 4 is to 5.